Hi everyone, today I'm going to be doing a review of Planetfall by Emma Newman. This is part of my Hugo Awards Reading Project. Planetfall, the series, was nominated for the Hugo Award for Best Series. It's a quartet of books. The first one is Planetfall, which I read. After that, the books are, let me check my notes, After Atlas, Before Mars, and Atlas Alone. It seems like each book in the series actually has a different setting and protagonist, and that they are kind of loosely thematically connected. They do appear to be happening in the same universe, but I think the author has said that you can read them all out of order. So anyway, I read the first one for this because, like I've mentioned before, there's no way that I can read all of the series that were nominated for the Hugo Award for Best Series, so I'm trying to read the first one in each series. And then I'll give my thoughts and also say if I think I would keep reading. Planetfall is science fiction. It's a pretty punchy first-person narrative. The story is from the point of view of Ren, who is a 3D printer engineer living in a colony that has been created on another planet. The colonists are from Earth, obviously, and they have been in this colony for about 20 years. She and the leader of the colonists pretty clearly have some secrets, but you don't really get to find out what they are until much later in the book. The technology that's portrayed in this book is pretty interesting. Everything that the colonists have is basically 3D printed, and then they're recycling things they don't need so they can print more things. They also have advanced medical technology, and everyone has chips in their head that are sort of like being connected to the internet, where they can have forums and message each other and things like that, but they're getting it in their field of vision. This little colony is at the foot of something that the colonists call God City, which is some sort of bioorganism structure thing that is not really explained, and it's not clear if they even really know what it is, but they have come to this planet both as scientists, but also their former leader was kind of a religious leader prophet as well, so apparently it was pretty controversial back on Earth. So at first this colony seems like a little paradise, but it becomes apparent pretty quickly that that is absolutely not the case. Like I mentioned, the original leader of the cult, Li Sumi, was a sort of prophet and religious figure, and she had some sort of vision back on Earth that led her to bring the colonists to this place, but it seems like when they made Planetfall 22 years earlier, some things went wrong. Sumi has been apparently in God City for all this time, communing with God or something. Nobody sees her except they get a message from her once a year, and some of the colonists seem to have not survived the landing. But then at the beginning of the book, a mysterious young stranger appears outside the city, and he is claiming to be Sumi's grandson. So her grandson, Sung-si, seems to have been the child of survivors that they all thought had died when making Planetfall, and so he is brought into the colony. He claims to be the only survivor from the people that he grew up with, and he is also adapted to the environment in some ways that the colonists are not. Like, he can eat things that are still poisonous to the people from Earth. So it's a little unclear what's going on with him, and they are welcoming him, but also it's pretty obvious that for whatever reason, the arrival of a newcomer is going to unbalance things in the colony in the way that they haven't been unbalanced before. Also, everyone in the colony is really surprised to find out that there were survivors from whatever the people were that died during Planetfall, but Ren, our narrator, seems to not be as surprised by this as everyone else, but we don't really know why. So we find out a lot of things as the story progresses. Although this is science fiction, it really did feel like reading some sort of dark psychological thriller with a really unreliable narrator. Ren clearly has a lot of secrets, but even though it's first person from her point of view, we don't get to find out what those are. We kind of find out gradually throughout the whole story. So that's a very particular method of writing where the author is sort of hiding things from us as the reader by having the character even deliberately not think about them. You can make up your own mind as to whether that works for you or not. To me, I thought it was pretty effective in this book. I definitely really wanted to keep reading and find out what was being hidden from me and what was going on, because it was clear that there were a lot of secrets you just didn't get the answers right away, even though the character knew them. To me, though, it does kind of damage rereadability of a book, because most of what kept me reading was the desire to find out what all these secrets were. So once I knew, I don't know how much I would enjoy reading that narrative again. There are also a lot of flashback devices and things like that, old recordings and memories and dreams and whatever that are used to gradually reveal what happened during Planetfall. I do think that the book had some pretty good twists that were well led up to. It wasn't one of those books where I figured out everything before we found out. Some things were obvious, but other things really weren't what I thought. So that was very interesting to read. There were also some things that got pretty strange, and there was some exploration of mental illness, and let's just say the main character was an even more unreliable narrator than what you might think at the beginning. I was in a bit of a science fiction slump when I started reading this book. Actually, I think I was in a pretty big science fiction slump where I was just feeling kind of sick of science fiction in general because I'd been reading so much of it lately because of this Hugo Awards project. But this book was definitely something different. It was kind of refreshing, even though it's a pretty dark book. And like I said, I did think it was an interesting scenario. I don't think I've seen a lot of science fiction that deals with the immediate to mid aftermath of colonists arriving at a new planet. At least, I mean, I haven't read a ton of science fiction, but I can't really think of too many books that fit that description. And in that way, it was more about the sort of social and political issues that they're dealing with, not so much the physical issues of dealing with getting onto a new planet and stuff like that. So the planet itself was not really a huge part of the story. So for all of these books that are part of series that were nominated for the Hugo Award for Best Series, I'm asking myself, would I keep reading this series? I think for this book, the answer is kind of a weak yes. I'm not dying to continue, especially since the book is pretty clearly self-contained. And by the way, I would say a lot of things get answered, but there are also some things about the ending that are super unfulfilling. So if you're somebody that likes to have things wrap up at the end in a really clear way that answers everything and is resolved, just maybe don't read this book. I think you'll be kind of miserable at the end. But I would consider reading other books in this series because I thought it was really interesting and different, and I enjoyed how the author built the story. But especially because the other books are not going to be directly connected to Planetfall, I don't feel like a strong motivation to continue. But unlike a few of the others where I've said this just isn't for me, there is clearly a part of my brain that does enjoy dark psychological books as long as they don't get too gross. So I would consider reading more of this series. So that's my review of Planetfall. Thanks so much for watching. Please hit the like button and subscribe if you'd like to see more videos from me.